Hey kiddos, and welcome back to music class. My name is Mrs. Liziola, and I am so happy that you decided to join us yet again for our continued study on the wonderful piece of music called Carnival of the Animals. Now remember, we have a word for people that write music, and that is called a composer. And the composer of Carnival of the Animals is a brilliant man named Camille Saint-Saëns, who lived a long time ago. Camille Saint-Saëns wrote Carnival of the Animals to describe lots and lots of different kind of animals and the way they sound. And he tried to make all of the music sound like specific animals, sound like how they move their bodies and what noises they make. And he used a lot of sound opposites to do this. So remember, this year we've been talking a lot about sound opposites in music. That's fast versus slow in music, and high versus low, and what that means in music. And then also loud versus soft in music. And we hear a lot of those sound opposites in Carnival of the Animals. We've heard them over the last few weeks as we've been listening to the lions in Carnival of the Animals, and the hens and roosters, the kangaroos, the donkeys, the tortoises, the elephants. And this week, we are going to hear them when we listen to the music of fish. Now this one, it's not called fish. It's called something else. The name of this movement, this little piece inside of the big piece of music, the name of this movement is named after where fish live. And it's not the ocean. It's like when you have a pet fish and you have a bunch of them in a beautiful display, and you can even go and see a huge, beautiful display. It's called an aquarium. So this one is called the aquarium. And in the aquarium, we can listen for the way fish sound and the way fish move. And we can do that by deciding, is it fast or slow? So some fish, they like to move very slowly, but some fish like to go really, 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 really fast, right? Like maybe if you've ever seen Finding Nemo, you remember that the turtle, right? He moves slow, and the jellyfish, they move slow. And even Nemo's dad, Marlin, he moves kind of slow. But then there's Nemo and there's Dory, and those fish, they like to go really, really, really quick. So we're gonna use our musician ears when we listen to the aquarium and see if we can hear fast moving fish and slow moving fish. We're also going to listen for fish swimming up high. And if, when they swim up high, we'll hear high sounds, right? When they're going up, 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 up. And then fish swimming back down, 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 down to lower sounds. So the fish might go up, 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 and then they'll swim back down, 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 down to a lower sound. That's how you can hear high and low in the aquarium part of Carnival of the Animals. You also might listen for loud fish and soft fish, all right? This is one of my absolute favorites, if I'm being honest. This is what an aquarium looks like, in case you didn't know. But I was thinking, before we go right into listening to this piece of music, I wanted to share with you one of my favorite little books. And it's not too long, it's a pretty short book, but I love reading this book to my music classes, and it's a great way for us to think about how fish move, and it's a great way for us to look at all different kinds of fish. This one is about a very pouty fish. Can you show me a pouty face? Yeah, like when you're throwing a fit or you really, really want something, right? And you're not really asking for it the right way, you might pout. That's what this fish does. So much so that he earned the name for himself called the Pout Pout Fish. Pout Pout Fish. And I wanted to read you Pout Pout Fish before we jump in to listening to the aquarium from Carnival of the Animals. The Pout Pout Fish. Look at him. There he is. Among all the other fish, and he is pouting. Deep in the water where the fish hang out lives a glum, gloomy swimmer with an ever-present pout. Look at him, he's so pouty. Let's listen to what he has to say. He says, I'm a pout pout fish with a pout pout face, so I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub. That's a pretty low sound, isn't it? Along comes a clam with a wide-winning grin and a pearl of advice for her pal to take in. Hey, Mr. Fish, with your crosstown frown, don't you think it's time to turn it upside down? She said he's frowning like this. And he should turn it upside down, because if he does, it turns into a smile. But I don't think he's going to like that. And here's how I know. Because he says the fish to his friend, "Nice thought, Ms. Clam. I hear what you're saying, but it's just the way I am." Oh, he's so pouty. He tells her, "I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face. So I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub." There's that low sound again. Along comes a jellyfish. He floats through the ocean, his tentacles all trailing in a gentle locomotion. This would be a kind of fish that you might see in the aquarium that moves slowly, isn't it? "Hey, Mr. Fish, with your daily scaly scowl, I wish you wouldn't greet us with a grimace and a growl." Says the fish to his friend, "Mr. Jelly, I agree. I'd like to be more friendly, but it isn't up to me. You see, I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face. So I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub." Very low. Along comes a squid, quite a slender, squiggly sight. She is squirmy, she is squelchy, she is slightly impolite. She doesn't have very good manners. Let's hear what she has to say. "Hey, Mr. Fish, you kaleidoscope of mope. How about a smile, a little joy, a little hope?" Says the fish to his friend, "Mrs. Squid, I would try, but I haven't any choice. Take a look, and you'll see why. It's because I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face. So I spread the dreary wearies all over the place. Blub, blub, blub." Oh, poor pout-pout fish. Along comes an octopus with 8 great arms, covered on the underside with tiny sucker charms. "Hey, Mr. Fish, let me tell it to you straight. Your hokey-bokey sulking is an unattractive trait." Says the fish to his friend, "Mr. 8, my chum, with a mouth like mine, I am destined to be glum. You see, I'm a pout-pout fish with a pout-pout face. So I spread the dreary wearies." Where does he spread them? "All over the place. Blub, blub." Can you say the last one with me in your lowest voice? Here we go. Blub. Very nice. Now along comes a fish in a silent silver shimmer. The gang has never seen before this bright and brilliant swimmer. She approaches Mr. Fish, but instead of saying hey, she plants a kiss upon his pout. Ew! And then she swims away. Mr. Fish is most astounded. Mr. Fish is just aghast. He is stone-faced like a statue. Then he blinks and speaks at last. "My friends," says Mr. Fish, "I should have known it all along. I thought that I was pouty, but it turns out I was wrong. I'm a kiss-kiss fish with a kiss-kiss face for spreading cheery-cheeries all over the place. So I'll smooch, 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 smooch." The end. That's such a silly book and one of my absolute favorites. I really like it, and I even like the part when he's pouting and he makes his voice go lower and lower and lower until it's very low. Could you do that part with me? The blub, blub, blub. Let's do it together. Blub, blub, blub. That time it's definitely going down, 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 down until it's very low, isn't it? Well, I want you to listen to the aquarium with me. We're going to listen together, and you can get very comfortable for this part if you're in a place where you can do that. You can get very comfortable. You can even close your eyes, and I want you to listen to the music and see if you can listen to the parts when the fish are swimming up, and see if you can listen to the parts when the fish are swimming down. Let's listen to that together. This is the aquarium from Carnival of the Animals.
your fish swimming all around me. This fish seems like it's swimming down. Do you hear that? That fish swimming down again. Again. And then back up. Wonderful. That is Carnival of the Animals, the aquarium. And I'm sure you heard lots of parts where the fish were moving down, and then lots of parts when the fish were moving back up. I really love that. For our next activity, we are going to pretend to be conductors. And a conductor is a person, maybe if you've been to a concert where there's an orchestra or a band or a choir, a conductor is the person who stands in front and they help keep the whole group together. And they do so by conducting with their hands, like this, or sometimes with a baton. Now, I don't have a baton with me here today, and I can bet that you don't have a baton with you at your house either, but that's okay, you can use anything that's like a stick. So I have a little pen with me, and if you have a pencil, a pen, a marker, a stick, a spatula even, a fly swatter, a drumstick, anything would work, as long as it's long and thin and you can hold it comfortably in your hand. We're going to practice conducting, okay? And we're not going to conduct the way that a lot of professionals do. No, we're going to conduct to match the direction that the fish are moving. So you can see right behind me, I have a picture of some fish. We start with a fish at the top, and then it goes down a little bit. So it goes up, down. Do you see that? Up, down, and then it happens again many more times. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And if I conducted with my baton, it would look like this. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And then it happens all over again right there. Up, down, up, down, up, down. And that's exactly what we're going to do. Can you try this up-down pattern with me? You can hold your pretend baton any way that's comfortable. And we're going to start up, so you can bring it up kind of high, and we're going to do this pattern together. Here we go. Up, down, up, down, up, down. Very nice. And then it happens again. Up, down, up, down, up, down. We are going to listen to the whole piece of music one more time, and we're going to use our pretend batons and follow this fish pattern for the whole song. We're going to follow when the fish move up and follow when the fish move down. I'll bring it a little closer so you can see it a little bit better. All right, here we go, conductors. Your baton to follow along, and then a big down. Beautiful. Do you see those bubbles? Let's go down with them. Very Very nice. You look just like conductors.
We know this pattern. Wonderful job, conductors. Down with the bubbles again. Nice and slow going down. These fish are swimming slowly down to the bottom of the ocean. We can make our batons do the same thing. This is a new pattern. Doesn't stay down. Look at this, the bubbles go back up. You ready to go back up? Here it comes. And you are all done conducting.
Wonderful job.
I had so much fun listening and moving to the aquarium from Carnival of the Animals with you this week, but the fun is not over. Before we sing our goodbye song, I wanted to show you that this week I have two activities for you to do, and you can choose just one if you want, but if you want, you can do both as well. The first one is a Kahoot, which we've done a few of those this year, and it is a little game or a little quiz that has fish moving up and fish moving down, and the only thing you have to do is listen and watch and decide if the fish are going up or down. To play that one, you'll click on this fish that looks sort of like Nemo, and it will take you right to the game. You just have to put in your name and start it up. I think you'll have a lot of fun with that one. The second one you'll see right here, I have a picture of an aquarium inside of a TV. That's because if you click this, it will take you to a real camera, real live video of lots of different fish in an aquarium. So if you click this, it will take you to a page that has lots of options that you can view live, real-time fish swimming around at the Monterey Bay Aquarium. I think you're gonna have a lot of fun with that. Let's get ready to sing goodbye. All right, snapping fingers ready. Here we go. Ready, goodbye everybody, goodbye. Goodbye everybody, goodbye. Goodbye everybody, goodbye everybody. Goodbye, everybody. Goodbye. Have fun.